Welcome back to Local 5 Live, everybody. We begin this half hour with a discussion about oral cancer, as April is the awareness month for it. And 42,000 Americans will be diagnosed with oral and throat cancers this year. The five-year survival rate of those diagnosed, just slightly more than 50%.
Early detection is critical because survival rates for early versus late detection can vary between 68% and 26%. Dr. Courtney Anderson is an oral surgeon with Bay Care Clinic and the Brown Door Kewaunee Dental Society's vice president, and she joins us this morning to talk more about this. Good morning, Dr.
Well, thanks for having me.
Yeah, let's start by talking about who is most susceptible in regards to oral cancer, and talk about some of the factors that might contribute to why oral cancer might develop in the first place.
Well, oral cancer is more prone to be diagnosed later in stages because, again, your mouth isn't a site that people are readily looking at.
Correct. Yeah.
But people more at risk are males, African Americans, smokers, those who drink excessive amounts of alcohol. All those elevate your risk for oral cancer.
What about smokeless tobacco?
That is also implicated, you know, so the studies are slightly different between smokeless and smoked tobacco.
Okay. We want to, if you're having breakfast, put it down a little bit. I mean,
it's not pretty, fair warning,
yeah. But, you know, the way that you really can spread awareness is to help people recognize oral cancer. So we have some photos of oral cancer in the mouth, and talk a little bit about the different ways that it presents.
Well, some of the most common sites, like this picture shows, is a white plaque that's kind of red and ulcerated. The site is on the tongue, so it does require the dentist to kind of pull your tongue forward and to the side to visualize, because just looking in your mouth, you might not be able to see, you know, these areas. But, you know, this is a little bit more advanced stage, so had it been detected a little earlier, the treatment for it would be a lot less.
And I know we have one more photo to show of this, if we can just, that seems pretty small, and that it's on the roof of the mouth, right?
Yeah, so really oral cancer can develop anywhere between the lung, the lips, the tongue, the cheeks, underneath the tongue, on the roof of the mouth as well. So really any site in the
mouth. When you have, like, growths or bumps like that, is this something that happens so gradually that you may not realize it's getting a lot bigger in your mouth necessarily? Or is this something that if you feel a bump or a lump that seems unusual, should you get it checked out?
Definitely, because sometimes you can detect it even at the precancerous stage.
Okay.
So treatment early with just a biopsy can help eliminate a lot of the unnecessary treatment and radiation potentially as well.
What about if we're at just a regular exam? If, like, I have an exam, just a cleaning coming up here in a little while. Is this something that they'll check for in your twice a year exam that you have?
Yeah, definitely. Even the hygienist will be taking notes, you know, throughout the cleanings. The dentist will inspect the tongue, all the oral structures, and really notice if there's any abnormal tissue. And then potentially, if there is, they would send you to either an oral surgeon or an ENT doctor for diagnosis.
Okay. Let's talk a little bit about some of the symptoms to watch for. If you're in between one of your appointments and something develops, what are we looking for? Well, I know we saw pictures, but they don't always look like that.
Correct. And like I was explaining earlier, you know, sometimes a patient will present with just a little scab on their lip. Apply bacitracin to it, thinking it's just a little dry patch, and then if it doesn't go away in a couple of months, like 6 to 8 weeks, then I would definitely have those spots checked out. Otherwise, any red or white patches in the roof of the mouth or on the cheeks, any unusual bleeding or pain, any lump thickening or rough spots in the mouth, and especially cancers of the tongue, if you have any difficulty swallowing, any, you know, pain with moving of the tongue, those would all be signs that maybe something's not right.
And one more question, because it doesn't always develop in a spot where you can see it. It's another interesting symptom is if you bite and your teeth don't fit together like they used to.
Correct, because sometimes it can also be involved with the bone. So a lot of times those will cause changes in positions of the teeth.
Okay.
But as you can see from the photos, even people who don't have teeth still need to see the dentist because unfortunately it does develop in sites that, you know, aren't readily accessible.
Important stuff, Dr. Anderson. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you. Yeah. All right, for more information, you can subscribe to the quarterly newsletter called Tongue in Cheek. That's on WDA.org. Or head to that website, look under Oral Health. And finally, there are some good resources as well on MouthHealthy.org.
Diamonds and Gold presents...